participation together with Americans for Democracy and Human Rights in Bahrain, the Bahrain Center for Human Rights, Human Rights Watch, International Service for Human Rights, the Committee to Protect Journalists, the International Federation for Human Rights, FIDH in France, OMCT, and International and Reporters Without Borders. Khaled, you didn't leave anyone. Thank you all. Thank you to all the organization and co-sponsors of today's event and for everyone gathered here today to join us for today's discussion. I would like to start with a general overview on Bahrain judiciary today to set the context for our conversation. Much of this overview can be found in ADHRB's written statement on this topic submitted for HRC 37 and can be found on HRC Extranet. 2017 was a notable year for the judicial system in Bahrain. The government amended the constitution to allow for the trial of civilians before the military courts, the first trial of which concluded with 6 death sentences and the stripping of nationality of 13 Bahraini citizens. Bahrain sentenced a total of 14 individuals to death in 2017 alone. The government has also continued to issue arbitrary revocations of citizenship after unfair trial and continues to abuse the human rights of its citizen under the guise of justice system, so-called. In 2017, Bahrain began the first military trial of civilians since 2011. In Royal Decree No. 18 of 2011, the King declared a national state of emergency following the pro-democracy demonstrations and established the two-tier National Safety Court with the Primary Court of National Safety and the National Safety Appellate Court. With the NSCC, where in fact they convicted an estimated 300 individuals. These national safety courts were later ended partly due to international pressure and the recommendation of the Bahrain Independent Commission of Inquiry, the BICI. The commission found that fundamental principles of fair trial included prompt and full access to legal counsel and inadmissibility of coerced testimony were not respected. The recent amendments to the Constitution allows for even more power of the military over civilians under markedly different circumstances. In 2011, NSCS were temporary and operated only for 3 months during the declared state of emergency. There has been no such emergency declared for 2017, and no language limiting the duration of military jurisdiction is included in the amendment. This has led some observers on the ground